In this lecture, I want to show you how vectors can be used to describe objects in three-dimensional space. In particular, in this lecture, I'll talk about lines, and in the next lecture, I'll talk about planes. This is called analytic geometry. So how do we describe a line in three-dimensional space? So we have some axis. Right, this is our x, y, z axis. And then we have some line in three-dimensional space. So here's some line, okay? We want to locate a point on this line using a position vector. So here is a position vector. So this is r. So we locate a point on the line using this position vector. So we would like to know how to express r. So we can have another point on the line. So let's call this point r0. So it has position vector r0. And to get to r, we draw another vector that looks like this, right? So that r0 plus this vector that points along the line gives us r. So how do we model this vector that points along the line? Well, we can call it a u vector. U will stand for velocity times t, say. So as we vary the parameter t, then we can move anywhere we want on this line, okay? So the equation for the line then will be the position of a point on the line is equal to the initial position plus the u, the velocity vector, times t, okay? So this is actually a particle then moving with velocity u. That describes a particle moving with velocity u. So this u then can be determined as a displacement vector between two points on the line, right? So if you take any two points on this line, you can construct a u as the displacement vector between those two points. And then t is a parameter here. So this is called the parameterized version of the line. So we can write this in component form. In component form, the I vector, the x component, would be x equals x naught plus, and if u is u1i plus u2j plus u3k, it would be x equals x naught plus u1t, y equals y naught plus u2t, and z equals z naught plus u3t, okay? Taking these together, we can eliminate t, and we get a non-parametric form for this line in three-dimensional space. Eliminate t, we get x minus x naught divided by u1, and that's equal to y minus y naught divided by u2, and is also equal to z minus z naught divided by u3. So that would be a non-parametric form for the line, because there's no t here. T is the parameter. Okay, so let's use this model for the parametric form for a line in three-dimensional space. Very easy to remember. Its position vector is equal to its initial position vector plus the velocity vector times time. Okay, let's solve this problem that I've written on the light board. Find the parametric equation for a line that passes through two points. the 1, 2, 3, right? X, Y, Z coordinate is 1, 2, 3, and 3, 2, 1. Then after we find the parametric equation, then we're going to determine the intersection point of the line with the Z equals 0 plane. Okay, so how do we find the parametric equation? So we need some initial points, so we might as well take R naught equal the vector, the position vector of the point 1, 2, 3. So that would be I plus 2j plus 3k, right? Then we need a velocity vector. So the velocity, the magnitude doesn't matter, it's the direction that's important. And the direction you find by a displacement vector between two points on this line, we have these two points. So we can take the velocity vector to just be the displacement vector between this 3, 2, 1 point and this 1, 2, 3 point, which would be 3 minus 1, which is 2 in the I direction, plus 2 minus 2, which is 0 in the J direction, plus 1 minus 3, which is minus 2 in the K direction. Okay, then putting it together, we have R is equal to R naught plus UT, right? So we get R equals R naught plus U times T, so 1 plus 2T times I, R naught plus U times T, there's no J in U, so plus 2J, and then 3 minus 2TK plus 3 minus 2TK. Okay, so this gives us then the parametric equation for the line in three-dimensional space. So R is any point on the line, and we can get to any point by varying the parameter T. So part B is determine the intersection point of the line with the Z equals 0 plane. That means we're interested in when the position vector has 0 in the Z component. Okay, that would be the intersection point. So this is A. And then B, we want 3 minus 2t equal to 0, which implies that t is equal to 3 halves. Okay? So when t equals 3 halves, the line goes through the xy plane. And then the intersection point then, so the intersection point will be xy, right, will be the value of the x component and the y component when t equals 3 halves. So 1 plus 3, 2 times 3 halves is 3, so 1 plus 3 is 4. So this will be the point x equals 4, and then y is always equal to 2. Okay, that's a 2. So this is the intersection point of this line with the Z equals 0 plane. So let me summarize. Using vectors, we can do some analytic geometry. The simple problem here is to use vectors to describe, to give a mathematical formula for a line in three-dimensional space. We do that by means of this parametric equation, where the position vector of a point on the line is equal to the position vector of an initial point on the line plus the velocity times t, okay? The velocity has an arbitrary magnitude or length, but the direction is specified by the displacement vector between two points on this line. Then we have a non-parametric equation for the line, and by using a parametric equation, we can answer a simple question such as which point does this line go through when it crosses the z equals zero plane. And that's what I do in this problem. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.